We're actually over-diagnosing breast cancer. And by some estimates, we're overspending about $4 billion a year diagnosing and treating this disease.
In order to achieve an earlier and more accurate diagnosis of breast cancer, researchers at the University of Michigan have developed a diagnostic pill that can enable screening and imaging at the molecular level.
At the screening and the diagnosis stage, it's really still at the anatomical level. So mammography is taking an X-ray of the breast and looking for a lump. And that doesn't really tell you whether that lump is dangerous or not. And so you need to go in with an invasive procedure with a needle, get a biopsy, when this patient may never succumb from the disease. The question is, how can we better detect the deadly cancers without over-treating the cancers that would never have caused the patient any problems? So that's where we decided to use near-infrared fluorescence to see if we could detect specific molecules in the cancer.
The idea starts with a pill, which contains a targeting molecule and a fluorescent dye called a fluorophore. The patient would take the pill, which would dissolve and release these molecule fluorophore pairs into the bloodstream. As tumor cells in breast tissue transition from benign to cancerous and new blood vessels form, there is an increase in specific types of cell surface receptors, which are proteins embedded in the membrane of a cell. So, the researchers design their targeting molecule to bind to the cells with these receptors and nothing else.
There are several different targets that we're going after, but one of the first ones we're looking at is AV beta 3 integrin. And that targeting molecule is a small molecule that binds to these AV beta 3 integrins, these cell surface receptors. And then attached to that through a linker is a near infrared fluorophore.
The fluorophore is a chemical compound that will absorb and re-emit light, which is used to image where the cancerous cells are in the breast tissue.
We're using near-infrared light because of that ability to penetrate deep into the tissue. Anybody who's ever taken a red laser pointer and put it up to your finger, you notice that the light actually comes out the other side. So your body is fairly transparent to near-infrared light. It can shine very deeply through the tissue, and it can actually go through centimeters of tissue, and that's what allows us to image tumors deep within the breast tissue.
A big challenge for the researchers was designing their molecule to work within an orally delivered pill.
If you look at the properties that you need that allow it to be absorbed orally, they're the exact opposite of the properties that you need for an efficient imaging agent.
For high oral absorption, the molecule needs to be small and greasy, so enough of it will be absorbed into the bloodstream. But for a good imaging agent, the molecule needs to be large in order to bind to the right target, and water-soluble, so it will wash away from everything else.
We thought this would be a good challenge. Let's take our computational models and determine what balance of properties we need to get a good orally delivered imaging agent. And what we found surprised us. We thought we would be somewhere in the middle of that spectrum, but it turns out most water-soluble molecules actually work the best. The charge on that targeting ligand appears to be helping the absorption.
And also, because the sensitivity of this imaging method is so high, less of the molecule needs to be absorbed compared to typical drugs.
I think this is a critical step. Once we get this out there, once other people, once other labs, other scientists see that this is possible, then the development of these types of probes will expand dramatically. I don't want to rule out mammography. Mammography is good, it saves lives. What we're trying to do is empower the physician to make better decisions for the patient, such that they don't have to undergo these tests needlessly. But the patients who do have cancer, who need treatment, will get that appropriate treatment sooner rather than later.